Hello and welcome to another Autodesk Alias quick tip video. My name is Johan Wendesten and today I will show you how to set up custom view layouts. No use delaying this any further, so let's get started. And the first thing I want to do is to save this single view layout as my default one. So I go to Layouts and User Windows, where I look for the Save Current Layout option, only to find that it's actually not there. And this is because I'm currently using the Subdiv workflow and that menu item simply isn't available here. So instead what I have to do is to switch to the default workflow. And once that is done, I'm finally able to save the current layout. If you have been switching back and forth between the default and Subdiv workflow, you may have noticed that there are indeed several other menu items which are not available in the Subdiv workflow. And if you are like me, not wanting to have to toggle between the different workflows all the time, here is a bonus tip for you. First of all, let's switch back to the Subdivision workflow, either through the menu or by pressing Ctrl 5 on your keyboard. Then go to Preferences, Interface, and Hotkey Menu Editor. Since here I can easily control which menu items are available in which workflow. So if I open up the Menu tab and then click Layouts and scroll down to the User Windows options, you can see that these two top boxes are indeed unticked, something that I can easily change by just clicking them to put a check mark in the boxes. Then I simply click Apply to save the changes. And now you will see that these menu items are indeed available in the Subdivision workflow as well. And with that out of the way, I click Save Current Layout to do just that. And let's give it a catchy name like Single Pane Layout before clicking Save. Now it's finally time to create our first custom layout. So I drag this arrow over here to resize the window. And then I want to close all the windows that I don't need. Also, let's move it to the top of the screen and extend it a bit to make use of all the screen space real estate that we have at our disposal. Then I go to Layouts to create a new window. And it's important that it is a perspective window. I click Go. And then I just repeat the process from earlier, using these tiny black arrow buttons to resize the windows to my liking. I save this layout just like I saved the one before, and this time with an even catchier name. What about Two Panes Stacked Layout? And then click Save. And what's so neat about this is that I can now use the Retrieve Layout option to quickly switch between the different layouts. So here is the default one. And here's the one we just created. There's of course no limit to how many different view layouts you can create. So before we go, let me just show you a few other ones which I frequently use. The two panes side by side layout and the three panes split at the bottom layout. While we're at it talking about viewing, I thought that I would address something else on this topic. As most of you probably already know, while you're in the perspective view, you can use this handy viewcube to change the camera angle. So as you can see, this is already quite quick and practical, but it turns out it can be even quicker and more practical if you are relying on hotkeys instead, that is. So let's go to Preferences and Interface to open up the Hotkeys and Menu Editor, where I first of all close the tab from earlier. Then I scroll down to the Special tab, where I open up Viewing. Here I can bind custom key combinations to the orthographic views, such as the left, right, top, bottom, front, and back view. I simply input the hotkey that I want to assign to the view, and in this case it's the one key. But as you can see, Alias tells me that the one key is already in use. While I could choose to simply override it, I don't want to in this case. Instead I want to assign it to a different key. So let's go with Alt 1. And when it comes to modify keys like Control, Shift, and Alt, it's not enough to simply press the key. Instead you have to type it out, like you see me doing here with the Alt key, for example. Lastly, I press Enter to complete the action, but it turns out that this key combination is also taken. But since reinvoke last is a command which I so seldomly use, I choose to simply override it for now. And then it's just a matter of repeating this step for all the subsequent views. I then click Apply to save the changes. And now I can switch between the different orthographic views by way of my keyboard, which is really convenient and very fast. And last but not least, whenever you make a change like this to the user interface, you mustn't forget to save the preferences. That concludes this quick tip on the topic of viewing. I hope you learned something, and see you in the next video.